It's Leader. Yes, it's me, Leader, the bell ringer. It must be a real shock to hear me speaking for once. It wasn't that I couldn't talk all this time, I simply chose not to. As I rang the crossroad bell deep inside my heart, I decided I would speak to no one. But the secrets I've been guarding are now starting to leak out. Lucas, the time has come to tell you everything. What I'm about to tell you, you might not want to know. So, even so, you absolutely must hear it. It is a long story, but please listen to it all. Yes. Given who you are and how you've lived, what I have to say will tear at your hearts. And there's just so much to tell. So I've decided to have the stinkbug trembling behind me memorize everything I say. Ready, Mr. Stinkbug? Long ago, there existed a world different from that, from what the people on this island, on these islands think of. The world was incredibly big. More people lived in the world than there are grains of sand on these nowhere islands. I know it may be hard to imagine, but such a world once existed, understand? Yeah. At some point, the world wound up destroyed. Naturally, it was humans who destroyed it. In the back of their minds, everyone had an inkling that it would happen at some point. And then it really did happen, and so the world is no more. Everything so far has been about the end of the world. Do you understand all of it? Yes. Just before the end of the world, a white ship came to these islands. On it were all the people of Tasmania Village, yes? Aboard the white ship were those few who had managed to escape the world, and the people on the ship still went by their names from the previous world. This white ship plan had been set into place before the world was destroyed. And although they're part of the world, these nowhere islands are a special place. They're the one place that would remain even if the world was lost. The one and only place where people should survive. And so the white ship arrived at these islands. Everything that has been so far has been on the white ship. Do you understand it all? Yes. Have you committed everything so far to your memory, Mr. Stinkbug? The reason these islands are special is because they harbor a giant dragon nearly as large as the islands themselves. Long, long ago, people lived together with the dragon. However, at some point in time, the people and the dragon could no longer coexist. So, using the seven needles, the dragon was placed in a long, long sleep by the ancestors of the Magypsy people who lived here since ancient times. Ever since, the Magypsies have guarded the needles, in the effort to prevent the dragon from being woken until its power is truly needed. Thus, until the time of its awakening, the dragon continues to sleep as the power of the earth itself. And so, because of the tremendous energy of the dragon hidden deep below, these islands were protected from the end of the world. Everything so far has been about the dragon and the Magypsies. Do you understand it all? Yes. Those who came here aboard the white ship feared another end of the world more than anything else. They felt the world's destruction was the direct result of the way they had lived. The people of the white ship discussed things at great length. They shared their wisdom and spoke with grave seriousness. And then they arrived at their conclusion. They decided to completely erase everyone's memories of the previous world and start their lives over with new rules and new roles. Yes, in short, everyone would play out the ideal story and that they had come up with. That's what happened. The people would restart their lives in a simple, peaceful village, in the kind of place they wished they had grown up in, and would erase their memories of everything, the world, their belongings, their rules, and then they would begin their new lives. Everyone's old memories would be reset and replaced in the newly created story, and thus the village of Tasmania came to be. However, it is necessary to record the fact that the memory replacement has taken place. The hummingbird egg was the device used to store the memories of the white ship people. Wes and his son Duster, both playing the roles of thieves, were set to take action should a dangerous situation occur. Remember when they went to Osoe Castle? They went there to retrieve the secret of the people of the white ship. And there's one more thing. Me. It is essential that one person retain memory of the previous world, so a sort of keep watch over things. I was the only one in the village of Tasmania who wasn't given a role in the new story. The sound of my bell served as a suggestion to keep everyone's fabricated memories from reverting. My name, Leader, it comes from the word leader. No, it doesn't mean I was anyone special, it's just that I was particularly taller than the others. So upon discussion, I was selected because it would be easier for me to stand out. Being so tall, people would want to see me, you know? And so I was given the role of revealing these secrets when the time truly came. Everything so far has been about those who lost everything. Although Tasmilly Village exists in reality, it was originally created as part of a story. I know this may be difficult to believe, but do you understand it so far? Yes. Let me also talk about Osoe Castle. Apparently, long ago, a kingdom existed on this island centered around the King of Osoe. However, when we arrived on the White Ship, the people of the kingdom were gone. It seems they left the islands, fearing the dragon's eternal awakening someday, before boarding the White Ship. Princess Kumatora was an infant who had lost her mother and father. Upon coming to the island, she was given the magic to raise and given the role of Princess of Osoe Castle. Wes and Duster, being the retainers, was another part of the fabricated story. Osoe Castle is one of the few and precious relics that the islands passed. We crafted our story in haste, so the people inside it would have very little past or history. Have you noticed that no one in Casmilla can talk about things from 100 or 1,000 years ago? In truth, we had wanted the castle an entire plethora of myths and legends, but our story was made in such a hurry that we weren't able to. It's a real shame. I'm sure that much of what I'm saying you'd rather not hear, but it's the truth. Have you listened to everything so far? Yes. Have you committed everything to your memory, Mr. Stinkbug? Truthfully, we had no idea how Tasmilly Village would turn out, but things actually went rather well. The people who arrived on the White Ship were fully taken to their new identities, and believed that they had always lived together peacefully. It was when a person by the name of Porky stumbled upon the islands that everything started to go amok. It seems he used the time distorter machine to travel through time and space at will. However, he is apparently shut out from all other times and spaces and tumbled into this era of these islands. Even worse, he used the time distorter to bring many people from the other eras here. The Pigmas, as well as everyone in New Pork City, were all brought here and brainwashed by Porky. The Porky fellow seems to know the truth of these islands as his own personal toy box, with which he can do anything he wants. He would take animal parts and recombine them to make creepy new chimeras. As a childlike director, he began doing whatever he pleased, including building Thunder Tower and forming his own army. Porky eventually learned the White Ship secret because of the traitor among the Mad Gypsies. You understand about the intruder known as Porky? Yes. The traitor was Locria, the 7th Mad Gypsy, and the only one you haven't met yet. After Locria joined forces with Porky, Porky learned of the White Ship people and the secret of the Seapling Dragon. Porky decided to pull the needles and wake the dragon so he could use the power for himself. The dragon is the power of the very earth itself, you see. It is said that whoever pulls the sealing needles will become the dragon's master. However, only a very slight few people are capable of pulling the dragon's needles. Apparently, neither the Mad Gypsies nor Porky had that capability, yet the needles are being pulled now. That means Porky is somehow controlling someone who can control the dragon's power. But we have to put a stop to Porky's antics. If we don't, the world will be completely destroyed again, and it will spell the true end for everything. For Porky, that might be the ultimate pleasure, but we can't allow it to happen. We, the last handful of people there are, absolutely cannot allow it to happen. Lucas, it seems you're a chosen one, and the ability to pull the needle stealing the dragon away. You must pull the Dark Dragon's needle with your own hands, and pass your heart on another dragon. Let this be my one and only order to you as your leader. Do you understand everything about the dragon's awakening? Yes. I hear that 6 of the dragon's needles have already been pulled. Deep in the earth, the dragon is likely beginning to stir in its sleep now. Supposedly, the last needle was somewhere here in New Pork City. Porky has been gathering everyone that lives in the islands into New Pork City to prepare for the final needle's pulling. It's possible that he's planning to hold one final twisted party. But now is our chance to change this looming crisis into a golden opportunity. All things may come to an end, and new and bountiful things may begin. Wouldn't you like to help that happen? Lucas, you were once weak, fragile boy, but now you've been given a tremendous role to fulfill. Now that you know everything, including everything that I'm sure you'd rather not know, the time has come for you to save the future of life as we know it. God won't make you bear more than you can carry. I'm sure you've heard that phrase before. Know that you're not fighting alone. Everyone, and I do mean everyone, will lend you their support. That was a long story, but that is the end of everything I have to tell you. Did you understand it all? Yes. Only the Mad Gypsies really know the needle's location, so I do not know where to find them. But from the way Porky and the others have been acting, I would say that they're very close to reaching the 7th needle. Please, Lucas, be the one who pulls the final needle. Porky issues his orders from the 100th floor of the Empire Pork Building. Start by jumping into the fray of storming the building. After that, you can start looking for clues. It's been such a long time since I've spoken to anyone, I'm now exhausted. This Stinkbug should remember everything I've said. Take him with you. That way, if you happen to forget anything I've said, you can ask him to repeat it. Will you go with them, Mr. Stinkbug? Alright, holy smokes. Yeah, that actually took so much longer, so I'm going to cut this off here, and we just heard this story from Letter, so I'm going to exit the pork building to add a few minutes to the clock, and then, actually not exit, but I'm going to go back out to the main area, and I will see you guys next time on Let's Play Mother 3, so bye-bye!